Welcome to the video Understand Dependency Injection in Java with me, Namhaming from codejava.net. In this video, I will help you demystify the concept of dependency injection in general programming, and you will know how it is implemented in the Java programming language. Let's start with the concept of dependency. So, what is dependency? You know, in object-oriented programming, a program consists of several classes, and naturally one class needs to use one or more other classes to make the program works. For example, we have the class client A and the class service B. Client A needs to use service B, so it has a reference to service B here. Service of type service B. In other words, the class client A depends on the class service B to do its job, so it is called dependency. You see, that's very simple, no more, no less. And this is the code of the class client A and class service B. For example, the service B class provides the getInfo method which is needed by the class client A. So the class client A has a reference service of type service B here. This is an instance view or member variable of the client A class. And in the do something method, here a new instance of service B class is created, and the method getInfo is invoked. In other words, the class service B is used. And in the main method, it simply creates an instance of client A class and calls the do something method on the newly created object, the client one object. That's very simple and easy to understand, right? And in the memory, there are two objects got created. The first one is an object of type client A. It is named as client 1. You see here. And the second object is of type service B, named as service here. In this code example, an object of service B is created inside an object of client A. Hence, they are tightly coupled with each other. If the object client 1 is destroyed, the object service is then destroyed too. And this kind of dependency is called hard dependency because the dependent class and dependent class are tightly coupled with each other. And you know, hard dependency causes some problems when the application's code grows and becomes more complex. First, the code is inflexible. It's hard to change, extend, and maintain because the classes are tightly coupled with each other. In the previous code example, if we want to use different service class, we have to modify the class client A and recompile the code. It's also difficult for unit testing because when you test a class that is hard-coded to depend on another class, you have to create an instance of the dependent class and you can't provide a mock object instead of the actual one. And hard dependency makes the classes difficult for reuse because they are tightly coupled. And when working in a team, it's not easy for two programmers to independently work on different classes that are tightly coupled. And to solve problems with hard dependency, interface is used. In the class A, instead of having a reference to the service B class directly, it uses the interface service. You see here, this is the interface service. And now, service B class becomes an implementation of service. So does service C class, and so does service D class, as you can see here. The client A class now doesn't depend on any specific classes. What it cares about is that it works with any implementation of the service interface. This makes the code more flexible, as we can change the actual implementation without having to modify the code of the client A class. Client A is now easier for unit testing and more reusable. And different programmers now can work independently on the class client A and implementations of service. Therefore, this is called soft dependency. The class is not hard-coded to depend on any specific classes. Instead, it depends on only an interface, allowing the flexibility of choosing the concrete implementation classes. As you see a Java code example, you see the client A class has a reference to the service interface here. The actual implementation of service is provided from outside via the constructor here. Constructor. The client A doesn't create any instances of service. Instead, an instance of service is injected by the outside code. And this is a service interface with three different implementations: service B, service C, and service D. You see, when the requirement changes, you can provide a new implementation, say a service E class, and the existing code remains unchanged. Is that flexible, isn't it? And now we come to the concept of dependency injection. There's an injector that is responsible for creating objects of classes. And in our example, it creates an object of service B class. Then it creates an object of client A class. Client A class has a reference to a service interface, and because service B is an implementation of service, the injector can pass the object of service B to the object of client A or inject. So this is called dependency injection. An object needs to use another object, but it doesn't create the depending object itself from inside. Instead, the injector creates the depending object and injects it to the dependent object. As you can see, then all the objects can be managed by a container. We can call it a dependency injection container. And to inject an object to another object, there are two primary ways. The first way is called constructor injection. For example, this is code of an injector that uses constructor injection. You see, an object of type service is created here, and it is passed to the constructor of client A class. And this is the code of the client A class. You see the constructor here. It has a constructor that takes an argument of type service here. So any implementation of service can be injected into client A class. And the second way to inject an object to another object is via setter injection. For example, in this injector code, service 1 is an object of type service. Its concatenator is service B. An object of client A is created here, client 1. And the object service 1 is passed into the client 1 object via its setter method set service. And this is a setter method in the client A class, you see. So far you have understood the key concept and principle of dependency injection with Java code example. And as you can as you have seen, dependency injection has the following benefits. Code is more flexible, code is easier for unit testing, code is more reusable, and it facilitates teamwork. However, dependency injection also has some drawbacks. It requires more development effort because we have to write extra code to configure the dependency injection or use a dependency injection framework, which requires more learning effort. And it makes the code difficult to chase because the construction of objects is separated from the code business logic, so it requires more effort to understand how an application works. And it can depend on a dependency injection framework. The code can depend on some code of the framework you are using. And thus, to understand dependency injection with a Java code example, I hope you found this video helpful, and thank you for watching.